think you can reach any higher, bud. That might be as high as you can go. What do you think? Here, you need some ankle implants. Oh!
No freaking way!
After being diagnosed with ALS, I asked the nation's leading ALS researchers, clinicians, patients and caregivers to join us in creating a business plan to ultimately end the disease. That monumental meeting led to what is now AnswerALS, the single largest coordinated ALS research effort in history.
AnswerALS is a project that thinks broadly and has brought to the table enough funding to do things the way that we want to do them.
Nothing could be better than bringing people who are all the best at what they do together.
Trying a drug that really is probably meant for a subgroup of patients, but we're giving it to everyone, and watching that drug fail and fail and fail is extremely frustrating. So AnswerALS's goal then is to en masse really bring in a large population of ALS patients to begin to personalize health for ALS patients.
This is a very different approach.
We've already enrolled nearly 75% of the 1,000 participants that we've planned to enroll. We've also created over 40,000 biological samples, which is what will set the stage for all of the biological research that comes out of this program.
Our remaining goals are to recruit the rest of the participants that we need to complete this study. The next phase is how do we interpret the incredible amount of data that AnswerALS is about to amass.
We're now looking for a much more sophisticated view of the same diseases. And what we really need to do now is be able to tap into the most cutting-edge machine learning and artificial intelligence so that we might have the opportunity to make new discoveries based on what we're already doing.
We have multiple independent labs with fantastic individual expertise, then with a shell over that of project managers. That structure, which it turns out has worked phenomenally well in this group, is one of the reasons why we're moving so fast.
ALS affects primarily, although not exclusively, motor neurons, which are the ones that cause us to move. That same neurodegenerative process is at play in other diseases, in Parkinson's disease and Alzheimer's disease, but in different cell types. A project like AnswerALS that is going big in one of these diseases will almost certainly have payoff in other diseases as well.
The remarkable thing about ALS is the types of people that get it. Peter Warlick, Steve Gleason. What's remarkable is they're fighters. Even though they have the disease, they seem to be interested in helping everybody else with the disease.
I refuse to believe there's not hope. And regardless of what path this journey takes me on, I'm all in the battle versus ALS.
I think a project like AnswerALS is really the antidote to some of the heavy parts of taking care of people with ALS. I need to walk into the clinic room with a pocket full of hope.
People do put their egos in a bag and say, look, let's just pull together.
Stem cell biology is primed to build on our platform. 10 years ago, it would have been too early. This is the right time to bring all the experts together.
At the end of the day, it doesn't matter what others believe you can do. It only matters what you believe you can do. And we believe AnswerALS is going to help end ALS. What do you believe?